about a garden green and gay. A seemly sight it was to see how flowers did flourish fresh and gay, and birds do sing melodiously. In the midst of a garden there sprang a tree, which tree was of a mickle price, and thereupon sprang the rose so red, the goodliest that ever sprang on rice. This rose was fair, fresh to behold, springing with many a royal lance. A crowned king with a crown of gold, over England, Ireland and France. Then in came a beast men call a boar, rooted this garden up and down. By the seed of the rose he set no store, but afterwards it wore the crown. He took the branches of this rose away, and all in sun did them tear, and he buried them under a clod of clay, swore they should never bloom nor bear. Then came in an eagle gleaming gay, of all fair birds well worth the bear. He took the branch of the rose away, and bore it to Latham to his nest. But now is this rose out of England exiled. This certain truth I will not lame, but if it please a while, I'll tell how the rose came in again. At Milford Hone he entered in to claim his right, was his delight. He brought the blue boar in with him, counter with the boar so white. Then a messenger the rose did send to the eagle's nest, and bid him hie to my father the old eagle. I me commend his aid and help, I crave speedily, since I desire my father at my coming of men and money at my deed, and also my mother of her dear blessing, the better then I hope to speak. When the messenger came before the eagle, he kneeled him down upon his knee. Says, well greeteth you my lord the rose, he hath sent you greetings here by me. safe from the seas. Christ hath him sent. Now he is entered England within. Let us thank God, the old eagle did say, he shall be the flower of all his kin. Wend away, messenger, with might and main, it's hard to know who a man may trust. I hope the rose shall flourish again and have all things at his own last. Then Sir Isaac Thomas draws Wales with him, a worthy sight it was to see. How the Welshmen rose holy with him and chopped at them to Shrewsbury. At that time was Bailey in Shrewsbury, one Master Meaton in the town. The gates were strong and he made them fast, and then the portcullis he let down, and through a garret of the walls, over seven, these words said he, at these gates no man enter shall. But he kept him out a night and a day. These words Mitten did old Richmond tell. I'm sure the chronicles will not lie. But when letters came from Sir William Stanley, gates were open presently. Then entered this town the noble lord, the Earl Richmond, the rose so red, the Earl of Oxford with a sword would have smitten on the bailiff's head. But hold your hand, says Earl Richmond, for his love that died on a tree. For if we begin to head so soon, in England we shall bear no degree. What offence have I made thee, said Earl Richmond, that thou kept me out of my own town? I know no king, says Mitten then, but Richard now that wears the crown. Why, what wilt thou say, said Earl Richmond, when I have put King Richard down? Why, then I'll be as true to you, my lord, after the time that I am sworn. Were it not great pity, said Earl Richmond, that such a man as this should die, such loyal service by him done. The chronicler of this, oh, will not lie. Now, shall not be harmed in any case. He pardoned him presently. They stayed not past a night and a day, but towards Newport did they hie. But an Atherton these lords did meet, a worthy sight it was to see, how Earl Richmond took his hat in his hand. Said Cheshire and Lancashire, welcome to me. But now is a bird of the eagle taken from the White Boar. He cannot flee. Therefore the old eagle makes great moan. Praise to God, most certainly. O steadfast God, verament he did say, three in one, God in Trinity. Save my son, the young eagle, this day, from all false craft and treachery. Then the blue boar the vanward had, he was both wary and wise of wit. The right hand of them he took, the sun and wind of them to get. Then the eagle followed fast upon his prey, sword dints he did them smite. The Talbot he bit wondrous sore, so well the unicorn did him quite. And then came in the harter's head a worthy sight it was to see. The jackets that were of white and red, how they laid about them lustily. But now is the fierce field fought and ended, and the White Boar there lies slain. And the young eagle is preserved and come to his nest again. But now this garden flourishes fresh and gay, with fragrant flowers comely of hue, and gardeners it doth maintain. I hope they will prove just and true. Our king he is the rose so red, that now does flourish fresh and gay. Confound his foes, Lord, we beseech, of his grace both night and day.